Hey guys, as I film this, it is Friday, December 5th, and it is also the first day of Reds Fest. And if you don't know what Reds Fest is, it is a huge fan festival spanning over Friday and Saturday, and it's presented by the Reds and Fox Sports Ohio, the TV station that broadcasts all the Reds games here in the Cincinnati area. And I've been to Reds Fest two times already. I went in the year 2000 when I was in the second grade, and then I also went in December 2008, my junior year of high school. So it's been 6 years since I've been, and luckily this year I'm going for a third time. I got two-day passes for the event. You can see Devin Mesoraco on the cover right there. And it's a ton of fun. You get to meet a lot of Reds players, get a lot of Reds autographs. Plus, you can also see some of the memorabilia that the team has. They usually have jerseys, baseballs, bats on display. And they also have the World Series trophies, or at least they did the last time I went in 08. But they had all the World Series trophies on display, which is pretty cool. And I wonder what they'll have different this year. As I said, it's been 6 years since I've last been. And hopefully I get a ton of autographs and meet a ton of players. Alright guys, we made it to the Duke Energy Center. This is where Reds Fest 2014 will be. Making my way to the entrance right now. Got a flying pig on my right. There it is. Welcome to Reds Fest 2014. Alright, so I'm in Reds Fest right now. Got a pretty cool back sack with the All-Star logo on it. Got a Reds lanyard with my ticket in it. And let's see who we can meet today. Got a ton of stuff here. Got more stuff on this side. There's even foosball and a Reds pool table. If you're a season ticket holder, you get to go to the Ultra Lounge, and unfortunately I am not because I can afford it, but pretty nice. Got a monstrous Mr. Redlegs here. The world's longest baseball bat at Reds Fest. This is a massive line. Welcome to Reds Fest.
When we grew up down by the railroad tracks, you babies and old beer cans, choking on smoke from a lucky strike somebody.
Oster autograph. That's a line for season ticket holders to get the Brennemans autographs and a few of the coaches, but it goes all the way back there. And the entrance is right there, so they got quite a wait. Todd Benzinger signing autographs. Thanks, Benzinger. Waiting for Jack Billingham's autograph. Got Billingham's autograph. Waiting in the Hall of Fame section, and Eric Davis on stage. Trying to get his autograph. There's Eric Davis.
Actually, where you wanted it?
Where? That looks good.
That's really cool.
There you go.
Got Eric Davis. 1975 World Series trophy, 1976, 1990. Spin the wheel to win some bobbleheads. They got, it's like Larkin and O'Toole, and right there is the Eric Davis one. So got a live auction going on at Reds Fest. You can get bobblehead, autographed baseballs, Johnny Bench autographed home plate. A lot of cool stuff going on. Buddy the River Bat, minor league affiliate of the Reds. Got a Reds pool table here. And this one, which is in Barry Larkin's condo during his career, which is pretty awesome. It's got air hockey, foosball. If I had money, I'd be in heaven right now. Got baseballs, bats, cards, jerseys, bobbleheads.
this booth has a couple of Twin Enterprise bobbleheads, as well as stadium giveaway ones, too. For Gary Nolan and Wayne Granger right now.
Got Granger, there's Nolan.
Waiting for Jim Maloney's autograph now. Got Maloney's autograph. Q&A with the coaches and owners with the fans. Waiting in line for Mike Leake. First minor red autograph of the day. Mike Leake has just arrived. Mike Leake's autograph. Standing in the middle of Reds Fest waiting for the last autograph session to be announced. Marty Brenneman, Hall of Fame Reds announcer. We're getting Mr. Perfect's autograph. Tom Browning. Got Tom Browning's autograph. Waiting for Sam LaCure's autograph. There's Sam LaCure's autograph. Got all four Reds mascots. Got Mr. Red on the left, Mr. Red Leg with a mustache, Rosie's the girl, and Gapper's the Muppet looking guy. It's the world's largest baseball. Also got some speed pitch at Reds Fest. And on the other side, you got batting cages. It's pretty cool. There's also an indoor wiffle ball field on one side, and looks like another wiffle ball field on the other, but this one's only used for batting practice right now.
So I just got back from Reds Fest, and to give you guys a quick little recap of everything I got there, I'm going to show you the autographs and the swag bag and all that stuff. So let's start off with the swag bag. Really nice drawstring bag. It's got the All-Star logo on there, Reds Fest. And they had some pretty cool stuff. Get a Frisbee, KOI Frisbee in there. And then they also had a really neat program. Here's the program. You got Brandon Phillips, Jay Bruce, and Devin Mesoraco on the cover. And it also has a team photo in the back, which, I don't know. If I already have a player's autograph on a baseball, I might get this signed. But, I don't know, we'll see. And then they also had talking like coupons and stuff in here, but they also had a All-Star Game ornament in there. There's a little pouch it comes in, and the actual ornament itself is red, and it's like a squishy stress ball type of thing, but it says Reds on one side, and on the other side you got the All-Star logo, which looks really nice. And that's a really cool gift. They usually never give out ornaments. This is the first time I've ever gotten an ornament from Reds Fest. Yeah, but that's a swag bag. And then there was this one booth there that I was also given out a pretty cool poster of the Reds. I think it was Kroger and Slim Jim, maybe. It has a 2014 year in photos, which you can see all the different photos on there. Really nice. Just wish the season would have had a better result than it did for the Reds, but a really nice poster nonetheless. And then the autographs. So in total, I ended up getting 10 autographs from day one, and that's the most I've ever gotten at a Reds Fest. And give you a quick little review of what the autographs I got. Start out with, who is this? Todd Benzinger, right there. And Benzinger, actually, when I went up to get his autograph, he was wearing his 1990 World Series ring. And I said, that's a gorgeous ring. He said, you want to see it? So he took it off and gave it to me to look at. So I was actually holding it in my hands, and it's just a beautiful ring. Gold with a C made out of diamonds. It's really nice. And then here is Ron Oster's autograph. And then I also got from the 1990 team. Let me see if I can get it out of this bag. This bag's about to rip. I usually keep my baseballs, autographed baseballs, in the bag so the ink doesn't smear. Well, anyway, here's a Gary Nolan. He has a really nice signature. Gary Nolan Reds 38. He just filled that up really nice. Who else is in this bag? This one. Wayne Granger right there. Nice signature too. very readable from the 1990 team, Eric Davis. I was stoked to get his, and I almost didn't get it. I signed up for the service where the Reds will send out a text message of who's going to be at what autograph booth, and the time he was signing, they didn't put him in the message, so I had no idea. So when I was waiting in line for this guy, Jack Billingham, I actually saw on a screen that Eric Davis was signing. So once I got his autograph, I bolted, was looking for Davis, and luckily I found him. And I was one of the few people to get in line before they cut it off. So I was pretty lucky. And who's on this ball? Get it out. Oh, we got Sam LaCure. He was the last autograph of the night I got. Nice guy. Talked to pretty much everybody who came up and wanted his autograph. Then also, from the 1990 team, Mr. Perfect, Tom Browning. I didn't know he was going to be signing, so I was pretty excited to get that. And then the last two I have here are, let me get this out. This one is Mike Leake. Doesn't look like Mike Leake, but that's his signature apparently. And last but not least, we got Jim Maloney. Really excited to get his autograph. So, 10 autographs on 10 different baseballs. Most I've gotten at Reds Fest. And, oh, I also got this cool little lanyard. It's got the, again, has the All-Star logo on it and the Red C. But it's for carrying the pass, which, as I told you guys earlier, two-day pass. So I will be going back tomorrow. And hopefully I will get even more autographs, meet even more players. So stay tuned for day two of Reds Fest 2014, and thanks for watching.